people all over the world celebrate some of the same holidays we do, and some different ones too. In Mexico, Cinco de Mayo is like our 4th of July. And my Chinese friends celebrate New Year's with a parade led by a dragon. Those sure do sound like fun, but I think my favorite holiday is one I get to celebrate right in my own neighborhood, Halloween. Halloween is costumes and lots of spooky fun. Shouting trick or treat and saying boo to everyone. Holidays are happy times, everyone filled with cheer. How I wish each holiday would happen twice a year. Last Halloween, my little brother dressed up as a pirate. There were lots of other pirates on our block, so my little brother counted them. You can count them too. Put one finger up in the air for every pirate and sing along. One little, two little, three little pirates. Did you put three fingers up in the air? Good. Four little, five little, six little pirates. Seven little, eight little, nine little pirates. 10 little pirates, yo-ho. But you know what? After each pirate filled his treasure bag with candy and apples and stuff, he went home. So now you put one finger down for each pirate and sing along. 10 little, 9 little, 8 little pirates, 7 little, 6 little, 5 little pirates, 4 little, 3 little, 2 little pirates, 1 little pirate, yo-ho. And that last little pirate was my brother. But pretty soon, his treasure bag was filled so full, he could hardly carry it. And mine was too. And then you know what? We both went home. Do you know what holiday happens on the first day of April? April Fool's Day. Is it one of my favorite holidays or what? I have lots of fun telling jokes and playing funny tricks on people. Last April Fool's Day, a lot of people got fooled at my house. As soon as I got up, I ran into my mom's room and said, "Mom, is your refrigerator running?" She looked kind of surprised, and then she said, "Yes, of course it is." "Well," I said, "if it's running, you better go catch it." Can you guess what I said then? April Fools! And then we both laughed. After that, my mom said, "Uh-oh, Cricket, it's 8:30 already. You better hurry or you'll be late for school." So I ran into my room and got dressed as fast as I could. Then I ran downstairs to breakfast. My dad was sitting there, so I said, "Dad, wanna see my new diamond pin?" "Sure," said my dad. "I didn't know you had a new diamond pin." So I reached in my pocket and took out a new dime. And then I took out a safety pin. Get it? A new diamond pin? Can you guess what I said then? April Fools! We both laughed. And then my dad said, "Uh-oh, Cricket, it's 8:45 already. You better hurry or you'll be late for school." So I finished my breakfast and packed my book bag as fast as I could. But just as I got to the front door, my little brother came downstairs. I had one more trick I just had to try. So I gave my little brother a pencil and said, "Here, would you write your name for me?" Well, that pencil looked real, but it was really made of rubber. And when my little brother tried to write with it, it wiggled and wobbled all over the place. Can you guess what I said then? April Fools! We both laughed, and then my little brother said, "Gee, Cricket, I just saw the other kids go by. You better hurry, or you'll be late for school." So I ran up the front door and out to the sidewalk. But I didn't see any of the other kids. And then I heard my mom and dad and my little brother laughing. So I turned around, and can you guess what they said then? April Fools! It was Saturday, and they knew it all the time. Here's an April Fool's game you can play. Just pretend you're the animal I'm talking about. First, you're gonna be a whale. There's a whale swimming around in my sink, swimming from side to side. There's a whale swimming around in my sink, he certainly couldn't hide. There's a whale swimming around in my sink, and there's something else besides. Yes, I'm sure there's something else besides. Now be a camel. There's a camel galloping round in my house, a camel upon my word. There's a camel galloping round in my house, at least that's what I've heard. There's a camel galloping round in my house, and there's something that's quite absurd. Yes, I'm sure there's something quite absurd. A gorilla is swinging around in my yard, swinging from tree to tree. A gorilla is swinging around in my yard. In fact, there are two or three. A gorilla is swinging around in my yard. I'm sure this could never be. Yes, I'm sure. I'm sure. I'm sure this could never be. Unless it's April Fool's. Holidays are so much fun. Holidays are great. No matter which one's coming up, I can hardly wait. Holidays are happy times, everyone filled with cheer. How I wish each holiday would happen twice a year. Christmas time is music, presents and a tree. Hanukkah and New Year's are as lovely as can be. Holidays are happy times, everyone filled with cheer. How I wish each holiday would happen twice a year. Last Christmas, I got some great presents. And you know what? They all started with the letter C. I'm making a list of them, and you can help me. I'll say on the first day of Christmas, I got a coconut. What did I get? And you say a coconut. Each time, I'll add a new thing to my list. See how many you can remember. Here we go. On the first day of Christmas, I got a coconut. What did I get? On the second day of Christmas, I got a coconut and a cake. What did I get? On the third day of Christmas, I got a coconut, a cake, and a cat. What did I get? On the fourth day of Christmas, I got a coconut, a cake, a cat, and a canary. What did I get? Did I get some silly presents or what? Last Christmas, I sang Christmas carols with my friends Cindy, Lou, and Susan. We went to all the houses on our block. Only problem was, there was only one carol we all knew all the words to. So we sang it a lot. It's called, We Wish You a Merry Christmas. If you know it, sing along. We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We want some figgy pudding, we want some figgy pudding, we want some figgy pudding and we want it right now. We won't go until we get some, we won't go until we get some, we won't go until we get some, so bring it right here. Then Susan said, hey, I know another way to sing We Wish You a Merry Christmas. And this is what she sang. We wish you a happy Hanukkah, we wish you a happy Hanukkah, we wish you a happy Hanukkah and a joyous new year. Well, now that I've had lots of time to think about it, I finally decided what my favorite holiday is. It's Christmas. On Christmas Eve at my house, everybody always gets together in front of the fireplace for a story. Storybook adventures, they're the greatest kind. There's no end to all the fun you'll find. You can have adventures and still be safe at home with a storybook adventure of your own. Storybook adventures, just for me and you. We'll find such exciting things to do. You can have adventures if you just pretend. All you need's a story and a friend. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. That's the start of my dad's favorite Christmas story. He reads it every Christmas Eve. Even though my little brother always falls asleep in my mom's lap. But last Christmas, my brother said he was old enough to stay awake for the whole story. And you know what? He did. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, and we all hoped that Santa soon would be there. As soon as my dad read that part, my little brother said, "Cricket, how come your stocking's bigger than mine?" And I just laughed and said, "'Cause I'm bigger than you." Then my dad said, "Here, Cricket, you read the rest of the story. I'll be right back." Then out in the kitchen, we heard such a clatter, we jumped from our chairs to see what was the matter. "Do you think that might be Santa?" said my little brother. "Let's wait and see," said my mom. We waited and wondered what made that sound. Then into the room he came with a bound. A bundle of toys he had over his back. "It's Santa," I said, as he opened his pack. He had a pink face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed. Like a bowl full of jelly. He didn't say a word, but went straight to the tree and took out some presents for my brother and me. He emptied his sack, and before he was through, he filled all the stockings, my mom's and dad's too. With a twinkle, he turned and waved to us all, then ran up the stairs as his reindeer he called. "Come on, Dasher and Dancer, and Prancer and Vixen. Now Comet and Cupid, and Donder and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Let's dash away, dash away, dash away all." "But what about Rudolph?" shouted my little brother. So we ran to the window and looked up in the sky. And we heard Santa say, as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Then my little brother said, "Was that really Santa Claus?" "Sure," said my mom, "if you believe he was." Then in another minute, my dad came back. "Daddy," said my little brother, "you missed him, you missed him. Santa Claus was here." And my dad just smiled and laughed and said, "That's okay, I'll see him next year." You're the very most fun I've ever found, and you're my friend. You're especially nice to be around, and you're my friend. I'm so happy I've got a pal to tell my feelings to. No one else means more to me than you. I'll tell you stories and I'll make you laugh, 'cause you're my friend. When we share, you can always have the biggest laugh, 'cause you're my friend. Though some folks think I act like a nut, I just wanna say, are you great or what? What a playmate you've been, thanks for being my friend. turn my tape over now, or you can look in your activity book for things to do that are all about holidays. But whatever you do, just remember, I'll be talking to ya.